It's been a quiet week in Lake Wobegon. I guess it has. I don't know. I'm a long way away from there. Haven't heard from them lately. Maybe things picked up as soon as I left. Don't know. It's happened to me before. Sometimes leave a party, for example. Kind of a quiet, dull party. People stand around and talk about public radio and its funding needs and go out the door, put my hand on the car door, and about then I notice the stereo is being cranked up. People hurtling past the windows. Loud whoops inside. Gotta keep that in mind when you're somebody as dignified as I am. And it may have an effect on other people. Notice that sometimes a little kid comes, stands up in front of me, look down at him. Poor thing can't remember his own name. I have to keep in mind that child's not dumb. Child's been struck dumb. Probably recover as soon as I leave. My God, people can be intimidating. And some people try awfully hard to be. Talking, through talk, I think, is how people are intimidating. That's why I like to sing. Because you're not intimidating when you sing. At least I'm not. Singing is a form of extravagance. Talk can be awfully intimidating. I think about my old high school teacher, Mr. Hockstetter, only person I ever knew who'd actually been in New York City in the flesh when I was a young boy. Came back home with stories to tell, including the fact that he had once paid $7 for a dinner. Which made New York an awfully intimidating place to some people. Lord, they thought, what sort of place must that be like? Lead a man to lose his senses that way. But to me, it was extravagance. It was wonderful extravagance. And I couldn't wait to get there myself. Extravagance different from intimidation. Extravagance needn't intimidate us. We can always just sit and watch it. Love it. My mother was the first singer I guess I probably ever heard, probably the same for you too. And I remember her sitting in a chair with a big fat baby on her lap that was falling asleep and belching. And she said, "You remember this song?" She said, this is a song I sang for you when you were little." And she sang it for me. And it was a song that went, "Joys are flowing like a river since the Comforter has come. He abides with us forever, makes the loving heart his home. Blessed quietness, holy quietness, what assurance in my soul. On the stormy sea, he speaks peace to me. How the billows cease to roll." It was one of her lullabies. She had a bunch of them. The first purpose of music, putting people to sleep. Still one of the best reasons to sing I know about. Takes you back, singing does, to a time before you could talk, before you were smart, when singing was the only way people could say that they loved you. I used that same song when I sang to my boy. It was number 3 in the repertoire of the evening songs, and I added a special little verse especially for him that went, "Blessed quietness, holy quietness, Hope you sleep the whole night through. Now your mom and dad will go up to bed, maybe make some more like you. Song of hers that I remember was her evening song, though my mother, when we'd be up on the hill up above Lake Wobegon School, up above the church, Our Lady of Perpetual Responsibility, be up there in the woods.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.